So earlier today, we recorded an interview with Wouter de Heij, the CEO of Top BV, who is a fantastic food technologist, and we're going to watch that right now.
Today, we're going to talk about extraction and phytochemicals derived from cannabis. And my guest today is Wouter de Heij. And how can I introduce Wouter? He's actually one of my gurus. When I have a difficult question about food or innovation or processing or anything like that, he's the first guy I call. He's like a walking encyclopedia. He is the CEO of Top BV, who does practical food innovation. He is the owner of Food for Innovations, of Blue Ocean Accelerator, and most of all, an inspirational speaker to me and a blogger. Welcome, Wouter. Good morning.
Hi, Maren. Thank you very much for this invitation this early morning. And thank you very much for these kind words as well.
Great to have you here. So when we talk about phytochemicals, Wouter, what are we actually talking about? Which kind of molecules and which benefits do they have?
Yeah, so if you take a look at the botanical world, so the world of plants and fruits and herbs and things like that, all kinds of fantastic biochemical compounds have been formed by these plants, often as a mechanism to defend these plants towards insects, for instance. But these phytochemicals are complex molecules that, besides having a defense mechanism, are often also very healthy for you. So one common examples are, for example, lycopene or lycopene extract out of tomatoes, or beta-carotene out of carrots. But many, many more complex molecules can be found in the botanical world, including, for instance, CBD in cannabis. And we start to, let's call it, reinvent or reanalyze the usage of this healthy, all natural compounds in this botanical world. And we will see what happens in the next decades in the industry.
Yeah, wonderful. I actually use CBD oil myself. So do you know where does that come from? From field hemp or from greenhouse grown cannabis?
If you purchase this CBD oil legally, then the chance that it is hemp, field hemp, is probably 95%. Because as you know, cannabis is a botanic which consists of two species. One species is the field hemp that does not contain any traces of THC, or at least very small amount of trace of THC. And then in the Netherlands, we also know, of course, in the rest of the world also, we know marijuana, which is illegal because it contains THC. But cannabis is the name of the group of botanics that can create, as well as CBD, terpenes, THC, and many, many more CBD-related compounds. And if THC is present, we call it marijuana. If THC is not present, we call it hemp or field hemp. So you swallow your use field hemp extract.
Exactly. So these days we can actually select and extract the molecules that we want, to have in our end product. So reading about this, we talk about extraction and refinery. What is the difference?
Yeah, let's take it step by step. So suppose you have a field hemp with a certain amount of CBD. So these can be grown in the field, but also in the greenhouse. But it is a botanic, a plant. So it's very difficult for us humans to digest these plants. So in the case of marijuana, so the THC part, we can smoke it, but it's better to take an extract out of it. What is extraction or extraction technology? You can compare it the best with coffee. So if you have coffee powder from the coffee plant, we put hot water on it, and all kinds of compounds that are in the botanic, the coffee botanic, are then moved or transferred from the coffee herb towards the water. And then the coffee as a drink is created. So this process where you use a liquid, sometimes a gas, but in the case of coffee, of course, it's hot water, to take out all kinds of compounds out of the botanics is called extraction or extraction technology.
Right.
And that is what we can do with cannabis and with in the broader sense as well.
Exactly. So is that difficult?
Extraction technologies have been applied for thousands of years, in the case of coffee, and in the chemical and the biochemical industry since multiple decades. In fact, we know a multiple amount of extraction technologies. We can use water, we can use ethanol, we can use hexane, we can use supercritical CO2, or many other extraction aids or fluids could be used. So the technology itself is known, but if you want to apply it to create food ingredients, of course you must have systems and technologies and machines that are a little bit larger, to have an efficient operation, that are operated in a clean environment. You don't have any pollutions. And in the case of extraction of hemp, fiber hemp, it's also crucial that no contaminants containing hemps are being used, because you can extract these as well. So the big challenge in the field of cannabis extraction nowadays is to ensure that we create a so-called full spectrum extract. And that means that we want to take out all the relevant components out of the botanic, out of the fiber hemp. So including terpenes, including all the CBG and CBD.
You're talking about a whole spectrum of molecules that you wanna extract, because they all have value, obviously.
Yeah, that is one of the searches we currently do. So most plants contain not a single molecule, but contain a full spectrum or a lot of biochemical compounds, these phytochemicals that are all a little bit different. So in case of cannabis, we talk about CBD, we talk about CBG, we talk about the terpenes, and if needed also THC, but many, many more that fall into this group of molecules.
Exactly.
The holy grail of extraction technology is to take out all these interesting phytochemicals into one step, mimicking the spectrum, or the chromatogram, of the original botanical plant. Because during breeding of hemp, you can decide what kind of compounds are being formed. A lot of CBG, a lot of CBD, less CBD, more THC, etc., etc. So that is breeding aspect. And the purpose of extraction nowadays, or at least modern extraction, to see whether we can take out the full spectrum of these healthy compounds out of that. Because there are indications that the health benefit of such an extract correlates with all the compounds. So not a single molecule, with all the compounds. It's called synergetic effect. Sometimes it is called the entourage effect. But that is more or less the holy grail nowadays of extraction.
Kind of makes sense, Wouter, because that's how nature meant it.
You can't beat nature. I call it smartness from nature. You can't beat nature. So if you want to take it out, this must be done.
And you're speaking of it like the holy grail. So does it mean that it is not possible today to do that full spectrum extraction like we want it?
On the market, there are roughly 4 or 5 varieties and types of extraction technologies. And not all of them take out all the compounds. So for instance, the terpenes are often destroyed. Or instead of extracting the full spectrum of CBD, you also extract all kinds of pollutants. So what happens often is that such an extraction is conducted, a so-called crude is created. Crude can contain traces of undesired chemical compounds, often contain high concentrations of CBD, 50, 60, 70, 80%. Unfortunately, in some cases, also the THC level is high. So what in the current processing world then is done is that this crude extract is or treated in a downstream processing technology. That means that we take away the undesired compounds, or that it is directly diluted to concentrations that are allowed according to, for instance, the European legislation. And that is the CBD oil you consume. This is a crude which is diluted with an hemp oil or an MCT oil or another oil to ensure that the CBD levels are known but lower than the crude and that there is no THC present. But this is just the starting point of the cannabis processing adventure that currently occurs.
Right. So when you look towards the future, how will this market change? How will this process change? So look ahead 5 years, Wouter. What do you expect?
Yeah, so what we foresee is happening is that cannabis as a botanic, the market for that will be limited only to B2B. So that means extraction, processing facilities, of course, they need to have the fiber hemp to treat. But it's a B2B market. The real consumer market will move towards fully edibles and drinkables, so directly to food or drinks. So you will see water-soluble CBD solutions as a drink. You will see it in coffee. You will see it in maybe in gummy beers. You'll talk about it later on.
Yeah. Okay.
But we might see even solutions where meat replacers will contain a variety of phytochemicals, including CBD. Why not? So what is building this, let's call it new industry currently, is the worldwide recognition of this all naturalness of phytochemicals out of the botanical world, but also the fact that these processing technologies, these all natural processing technologies, have been emerged on the market. And the consumer acceptance is growing towards phytochemicals, including CBD. So these three aspects are now pushing the innovation in the market, and the CBD oil consumption will rise, but more linearly. But we expect an exponential increase in CBD containing foods, drinks, waters, and many, many more applications. And to do that, we need to have powdery ingredients, or we need to have CBD that contained that are emulsions, or we need to have CBD being present in watery systems. So from a herb towards a crude extract, towards a refined extract, diluted in oil, that is already done.
Yep.
The next step is to take a look at food ingredients that can be applied in a variety of drinks and foods. And for that, part of the legislation is it needs to be changed, because we still have an issue regarding novel food legislation, at least in Europe. But also the QAQC system, so the quality assurance systems of the ingredient suppliers, must be upgraded to higher levels. Because if you want to sell to a big beverage company with brands these kind of ingredients, you must ensure them that the CBD levels are really at a constant level that you promised them. You must ensure that there are no contaminants being present. So the food industry, or the food ingredients industry, is now doing a lot of development in insurance that these quality levels are good to provide the big multinationals, for instance.
It's exciting. So one day food will be our medicine, like Hippocrates once said.
I hope so. As you probably know, there are also forces in this legislation part that if a certain herb does have a certain effect, that they soon will tell it's not allowed anymore to place in a food, in food ingredients. So,
yeah.
But I really hope that we reinvent the possibilities of herbs and plants and the smartness of nature in preventive medicine, in boosting our immune system, for instance, relevant now for the COVID situation that we are in.
Oh yeah.
And that we start to realize that we don't need to make medicines of every chemical or block the usage of this relatively harmless botanics and botanical extracts in the domain of food and food supplements.
Excellent. So Wouter, people can find out lots of information about what you do at top-bv.nl, top-bv.nl. But do you know any other resources where websites where we can find information, for example, on the extraction technology? Can you recommend something to us?
Yeah, the extraction technology that we use to test in comes from Phytonext, phytonext.nl. And it's the most advanced extraction technology currently on the market. And for others, Google supercritical CO2. Of course, we are a big fan of the Phytonext platform in respect to extraction technologies.
And that's Phytonext with pH, correct?
Yes, from phytochemicals.
Excellent, Wouter. Well, with this, we have to conclude this interview, not without thanking you for this contribution, for the information you gave us. And we look forward to having you again in our studio to talk about this topic and legislation and other things. Thanks a lot, Wouter.
Thank you very much. And good luck with the rest of the show.